The following is a morning walk conversation with His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on January 11th, 1974 in Los Angeles.
We always say that the best way to water the tree is from the root, but he says that the way that nature actually waters is from the top.
From the top, water comes.
By evaporation.
Right. In the clouds.
By evaporation of the ocean.
Who kept the ocean? What?
By nature.
Then you come to somebody. That is foolishness. The nature is not ultimate. Krishna is the ultimate. Because you cannot see Krishna, therefore you say nature.
Nature is under my control. Krishna says nature is under my control.
Yes.
It is just like an equilibrium, Srila Prabhupada. In science it is called equilibrium.
Yes.
Means it is on and off.
It is called...
It's almost constant.
Chakra. What is that? It's in Bhagavad Gita, it is said. Brahma Chakra. Brahma Chakra. Sadvam Khalidam Brahma. That is realization. In every action there is Brahma. Beginning by eating food grains, you become strong, the animals become strong. Then when you become strong, you perform yoga. And from yoga there is cloud, and from cloud there is rain, and from rain there is food grain. This is the chakra.
Cycle. That is the symptom of material nature.
Yeah. So this yoga means to satisfy the Lord. Yajñārtha karma. So when you miss this yoga, then everything becomes disturbed. When you become godless, then the whole thing will be disturbed. And practically also, if you pay income tax, then government arrangement is everything nicely going on. And as soon as you stop income tax, the whole thing, there is no finance, there is bias, deficit, these, that, so many things. So yoga is yajñārtha karma. Everything should be done for the yoga, for Vishnu. Then everything is in order. The yajñas are not possible. They were yajñas in Sankirtan. But this rascal will not take. If you say that this simple yajña, you take it, chant Hare Krishna mantra, all problems will be solved. They will not believe it, they will not take it. They are so misfortunate. Shastra says, yajñai saṅkīrtanai prāyi jajanti hi sumedhasa. Sumedhasa there. Those who have got good brain, they take up this yajña process. Sumedhasa. And another word is alpamedhasa. Less brain substance. Tadbhavati alpamedhasa. Antavattu phalamtesa. Jadbhavati alpamedhasa. They are doing all other things. But not yajña. Therefore, alpamedhasa, their brain substance is small. And here is sumedhasa. Yajñai saṅkīrtanai prāyi jajanti hi sumedhasa. That is the sign of merit. You do something which will produce good result. And if you catch some dogs, if you simply jump over, what will you do? That Lilavati Munshi of Bombay, she is the wife of a big man, K. Munshi. So Shiva is asking, Swamiji, how you made like this? Everyone is surprised. Because no one has done like this. Yes. I say that because I've taken the proper method. Therefore it is done so nicely. The method must be right. It may be simple, but it must be right method.
He is
Gujarati, Lilavati Munshi. Yes. Karachi Abhijay Bhavan. Bharati Abhijay Bhavan, yes. She invited me this time.
She is writer,
I think. Yes. She is very educated. Now, her husband made very great attempt for publishing book. But there is no sufficient customer, now this place is going to be sold. Uh-huh. And nobody customer. And there is later setting place. Now it is obsolete. So, their purpose. She wanted that I shall purchase, and what shall I do with this place? Letter setting is now abolished. Uh-huh. There is not good job now. There must be litho press. What is called? Offset.
Offset.
Since Krishna is the power that gives the demigods the ability to render everything, then why is it recommended in the Nectar Devotion that a Vaishnava should worship Ganapati? Why is it recommended in the Nectar Devotion that a Vaishnava should worship Ganapati?
Vaishnava worship everyone. Just like we worship also ordinary man. If it gives us facility to worship Krishna, we go to somebody and worship him. Flatter him, because he'll give some money and it will be engaged in Krishna's service. The man is not worshipable, but he'll help us to worship Krishna, thereby he'll be helped and we'll be also helped. And Krishna will be satisfied. Krishna will be satisfied that my devotee has brought some money from this rascal. All right. So Ganapati is also a devotee. So Ganapati, it is not required, but sometimes we do. Just like gopis, they worshipped Goddess Durga, Kattayani. They did not require, but the social system is there. But they asked that Mother Kattayani, give us the opportunity to have Krishna as our husband. The aim is Krishna. Generally, they go to worship Devi Durga, for asking material benefit. Dhanam dehi, rupang dehi, jasu dehi, these things which we want in material. But the gopis, they do not go for any material things, for Krishna. Similarly, we can go to any demigod. Why Ganapati? Everyone. But our prayer should be, please give us Krishna. Then it is correct. Whatever possible facilities available from any person, we beg for it for Krishna's service, not for our personal benefit. They forget Krishna. When they go to worship some other demigod, they forget Krishna. Kamasthastha hitagyan. Because they have got so strong material desires that they forget Krishna. That is harmful. Alpavattu phalam te